All right. So accounting methods, right? So we saw the accounting methodology before, right? And we saw it in terms of the direct, the manufacturing drawback, the manufacturing direct identification drawback. So here are the methodologies that we discussed. How you claim this, right? Now, the acceptable accounting methods for identification of merchandise are provided in four categories. Customs say it's four categories. There is a fifth line item category, which is pretty much used as for the separate purpose. And in four compliance publication breaks it down as kind of like a separate step. For the purpose of customs broker exam, keep in mind that inventory turnover has been considered as the accounting method that has been asked. So I include, even notwithstanding the informed compliance publication implication that is this, that this method is kind of like separate and distinct, I still include it as a part of the list, right? So what's important in here, and I wouldn't go into this too much because we need to know basic overall principles and the buzzwords to really answer the question, because some of those accounting stuff, they go deep into the details. Just by way of example, so let's go to the one of these accounting methods examples. Let's see, we are identification of merchant by accounting method. So here is the table, right? And we're talking about low to high method, right? So one way it is being used is, so the examiners use this method. So the low to high method, right? So they say, all right, so for this particular export is zero because right now you're picking off back on this one. So the January 15 export is zero. You cannot claim any drawback. Here it is also zero because you are still using that low volume of units, right? And then on February 5th export, you can claim something. February 5th, you can claim $150 for January 5th and January 20th exports, because you used up that zero over here, and now you move into here and to here to claim this one. So that's example of low to high method. You are welcome to go into the details. I would suggest to really stick to the details, because again, there is so much to learn. It would suffice to say, we've seen this in those methodologies already, the similar methodologies we've seen in the warehouse provisions, when customs examiners have asked questions on the warehousing bookkeeping practices by the warehouse operator. Here, it suffices to know that this is first in, first out, based on the oldest one being out. So first merchandise articles received in inventory, once they're out, this is you claim, how you claim. Last in, first out is the newest article being out. This is how you claim. The average or low to high, we just saw as an example where you really go back and forth, and sometimes you make zero claims, as we saw in the table. Sometimes you make sometimes you make claims as you go, right? Let's see. So this is low in low to high method, right? Lowest drawback amount per unit of the merchandise in the inventory. Average is, that, as the name implies, calculation based on attribution to each unit. So you do the proportion stuff. You have to do the proportions. And inventory turnover is, as the name implies, you make a projection and you see what is the amount of inventory that you had at any given time, depending on the time period that you look at. What we need to know for customs broker exam purposes is that customs can ask you about particular, it's not just a laundry list that they're asking, they're asking you about the particulars of each method. So let's, and you would be in a good position to answer this if you just know the general principles. You don't have to go into the itty-gritty details and to be able to independently go through examples to answer those the questions that relate to the accounting methodology. All right, so those accounting methods are applicable to manufacturing, to unused merchandise, and to rejected merchandise. If we're talking about manufacturing and unused merchandise, it must be direct identification, folks. It must be direct ID. It cannot be substitution, because if we're talking about the substitution, you cannot use those methodologies. There is another one. So substitution, petroleum, substitution unused merchandise, substitution drawback is not applicable. Trade-off is another process where you acquire domestic merchandise and you substitute it under 1313K. The question is out there, right? And again, remember, the 1313A direct manufacturing identification. So let me clear this out. Time and time again, this is the reason why I ask you to relate to the statutory provisions. Because whenever we see, where is my marker? It's in my pocket. So whenever we see the 1313A, immediately we know that we're talking about the manufacturing drawback, direct identification. 1313J1, we're talking about unused merchandise, also direct identification. All right, so this is what customs are looking for. And we know that those direct identification methods, right, they are going to this applicability provision. They're applicable to rejected, to unused, it's over here, 1313J1, and manufacturing direct ID, 1313A, right? So all those methodologies that are listed in the table, they are applicable so long as it pertains to this type of drawback type, right? So which inventory accounting method is acceptable for direct identification for filing drawback claims and provisions? Foreign in, foreign out, well, there is no such thing. First in, first out, there is. Deductive method, no. That's deductive. We saw deductive method in the valuation methodology, where you have provisions where you have to when you declare customs value, you have to start with transaction value. If it's not applicable, you have to go to the transaction value for the similar or like merchandise. If you cannot use that type, you have to go to computed value. Then you have to go to the deductive value, and then you have to go to like to the default approximation provision, the other provision. So deductive computed value you can switch if you make that request to customs, but that's where the word comes from. It pertains to not to drawback provisions. It pertains to the evaluation provisions. So that's incorrect. High to low? No. There is first in, first out, last in, first out. Quarterly closeout? No such thing. Last in, first out? Yes. Last in, first out is on the list. Last in, first out, LIFO, is on the list of the acceptable accounting methodologies. So this means that this is applicable because we're talking about the direct ID for manufacturing and unused merchandise.